If you need to share files on your home network, setting up an NFS server using a Raspberry Pi and an external hard drive, or SSD, is a quick and easy way to do just that. If you've been following my Kubernetes on Raspberry Pi series, the server setup we will create in this video can act as your persistent storage provider as well. Let's build it. To follow along with this video, you'll need a Raspberry Pi with Raspbian installed and the Pi set to a static IP. You'll also need an external hard drive or SSD with a USB interface. For performance reasons, I suggest using a Raspberry Pi 4 and a drive with USB 3.1. Also, the drive used in this video is formatted with the ext4 file system. You're free to use other file systems if you prefer, just be aware you may have to change some file system options at various points in the video if you do. Links are provided in the description to my other videos that show you how to install Raspbian and format a hard drive if you're not familiar with those operations. With those materials gathered, let's get started. First, we'll shell into the Pi with SSH. My Pi's static IP is 192.168.0.3, so that's the IP I'll be using in the video. We need to make a directory to mount the drive on. Let's use opt-nfs. Next, we want the drive to be automatically mounted when the Pi boots, so we need to add its information to etc/fs tab. Let's get the partition identifier. Copy the part UUID. Now edit etc/fs tab and add in a line to mount the drive. Save and quit. We could reboot and the drive would be mounted, but we can also mount manually just this once. Let's do that to save a bit of time. Okay, looks good. Let's install the NFS server. Easy enough. Now we need some things to export. Let's make a few sample export directories and files. Okay, now we need to tell NFS that we want these directories exported. We do that by putting entries in etc exports. The asterisk means that we want to export the everyone directory to, well, everyone. The RW flag means that we want the export to be readable and writable. We could have used RO if we wanted to make it read-only. The sync and no subtree check flags are defaults. But at some point, NFS switched the default values for these flags, so it will gripe at us if we don't specify them. Let's add one more export. By specifying the host address for this export, we are limiting access through NFS to a particular host. We could have also used the host names and/or the CIDR notation to limit access to a particular network or network subsection. If you're interested in types of restrictions, run man exports on your NFS server Pi. Okay, let's save and quit. Now we need to tell NFS that we've changed the export files and that it needs to reevaluate what it's exporting. That's all there is to it. So let's switch back to our PC and test the exports. In order to mount NFS file systems, at least on Ubuntu-based systems, you need to install the NFS common package. Without it, you'll get an error suggesting that you need a helper program when you try to mount. With that installed, we can temporarily mount the everyone export. We can now see the files from the export. We mounted the directory rewrite, so let's try to write a file. That didn't work. So what's going on here? This is where things get a little complicated. By default, the NFS permissions are the standard Linux file access permissions that limit access by user and group IDs. So in order to allow a write, the directory on the NFS server has to be writable by the user ID from the client. In other words, users and groups between the server and client must match. So what can we do? Well, one option is to just make the directory on the NFS server world writable with something like chmod777. That would work. If that trips your internal security senses, if you're managing mostly single user systems, we can take advantage of the fact that many distributions start user IDs off at 1000. Notice that the Pi user's ID is 1000. On my computer, my carpie ID is 1000 as well. This is because Pi and carpie are the first end user IDs created, and both Raspbian and Ubuntu start users off at 1000. So, we can just make the everyone directory owned by the Pi user on the server. Now we can write. If you're managing multiple users, you have a couple of options. The world writable thing is an option. Also, you could create a group on the NFS server and on each client machine with the same ID. You would then set the directory you wanted writable to be group writable and owned by the new group. On the client machines, you'd create the same group with the same ID and add any users with access to that group. That would work too. If you wanted to get real fancy, you could make the server use something like LDAP to manage users. I'm going to leave those options as exercises to the viewers. Okay, that's the unrestricted export. Let's unmount that and then try the restricted one. Good. It was restricted to an IP that is not my IP, so it won't let me mount it. Let's update the export to use my IP. And now try that again. Cool, now I have access. So the restrictions are working. So that's how we can mount the export temporarily. What if we wanted it mounted all the time? We just need to put an entry in etc/fs tab for that case. So we mount the everyone export on SRV this time, just to change things up. You can mount on almost any directory you want. We'll use type NFS. We want to mount read-write. We specify user so that a normal non-root user can mount or unmount the share. And we specify soft so that our connections don't hang if the server crashes or we lose connection. Finally, we don't want to dump the file system and we don't need fsync to check it, so we use 0 and 0 for the final two parameters. Okay, save and exit. Now we can mount as a normal user just by saying mount/srv. Also, the share will be mounted automatically when we reboot. If we wanted the easy mount SRV mounting but didn't want to mount automatically on boot, we could add the no auto option in the FS tab line. If you want to know more about the available options, try running man NFS. There we go, we have a working NFS server. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. If you like this video and would like to see more, please consider subscribing to my channel.